Hi everyone. In this video, I am going to explain about the control statements. Before going to learn something about the control statements, we need to know something about what is the statement. Statement means anything that should end with the semicolon is called statement. For example, observe here. I am having a one first line. And second line, third line, fourth line, fifth line, sixth line, seventh line, eighth line. Normally, any programming language execution will start at the like a top. This is the like a top, and this is the left. Any program will start the program execution at the like a top left, and the program execution will end at the bottom right. This is the normal flow of the program execution. But all are called as like here, for example, here we are having the multiple statements. So what is the use of the like control statement means? For example, we are going to put the one particular condition. For example, observe here. Here I am having the like 8 lines are there, means 8 statements are there. In the fourth line or fourth state, in the fourth line, I am putting the one condition. So what I am doing is, normally program will start the program execution at the top left. So whenever it came to the like line number 4, it will check the condition. If the condition is true, then only this fourth block, this fourth line will execute. Otherwise, it will not go into the like particular block. Again, I am repeating. So using the control statement, you can able to check the condition. For example, in the fourth line, I am putting the one condition. If the condition is true, then only fourth line will work. Otherwise, fourth line will not work. Means normally any program execution will start from the top left to bottom. So here normally this program is going to start the like program execution from the top to bottom. Normally, it won't stop any program execution in the middle. But if you are using the control statement, means it won't execute the like all the lines. For example, in the fourth line, you are putting the condition. If the condition is satisfied or condition is true, then only this block will work. Otherwise, this block will not work. That is advantageous. So finally, I can say that here the statement is nothing but a anything that should end with the semicolon. Normally, in any programming language, program execution will start at the top left and program execution is going to end at the bottom right. But in case of the like control statement, what is the use of the control statement means, with the help of the control statement, we are going to check the condition. If the condition is true, then only this block will execute. If the condition is not true, then particular block will not execute. So we will check the what are the control statements are there. So we are having the different types of the like control statements. First of all, what is the use of the control statement means, using the control statement, we will check the we will handle the program execution flow. Using control statements, we will handle the normal flow of the program execution. Again, I am repeating. What is the use of the control statements means, using the control statement, we can able to handle the normal flow of the program execution. That is means, using the control statements, we will check the condition. Using control statements, we will check the condition. Check the condition. If condition is true, then particular block will execute. So what is the use of the control statement means? Using the control statement, we can able to check the, we can able to handle the normal flow of the program execution. What is the meaning of the like normal flow of the program execution handling means? Using the control statements, using the control statement, we will check the condition. Means we first of all, we will put the one condition. If the condition is true, then particular block will execute. If the condition is not true, then the particular block will not execute. Means here we are having the different types of the like control statement. For example, first I am having a if and I am having a like a else block. If and else I am having. So here what is the if means? If is nothing but a, if is a one of the control statement. So what it will do is it will check the condition in the beginning itself. It will check the condition in the beginning itself. So why it is checking the condition means, if the condition is true, then only if block will execute. If the condition is not true, then it will not execute. If the condition is true, then only if block will execute. Otherwise, if you block will not execute. So I am going to write the like one thing here. For example, I am having a where age is equal to, I am having a like 17. So this 17 is the like value. This 17 value I am assigning to a like age variable. So now with the help of the if statement, I am going to check the condition. For example, if age is greater than or equal to 18, then only the particular person is eligible for vote. If the age is below the like a 7, below the 18, then he is not eligible for vote. So this one I am going to write here. Document dot write ln of here. If it is like eligible, then you are eligible for vote. So again I am repeating, if is nothing but one of the control statement, using the control statement you are going to check the condition in the beginning. First I am going to explain here. If is a one of the control statement. So what is the use of the if statement means, it will check the condition in the beginning itself. Means here is the like a condition, it is going to check the condition. If this condition, next statement is, if the condition is true, then only if block will execute, otherwise if block will not execute. Means here we are checking the condition. If the age is greater than or equal to 18, then only this block will execute, otherwise this block will not execute. Means if is nothing but one of the control statement, it will check the condition. If the condition is true, then only if block will execute. If the condition is not true, then if block will not execute. Then in that situation, to show the something results to the like user, we have to write the else part also. For example, if the age is greater than or equal to like 18, then the if block will execute. If it is not like greater than or equal to 18, then else part will work. So here we have to show something called as document dot write ln of, like here you are not eligible for vote. You are not eligible for vote. Means what we are doing, we are checking the condition. So where is nothing but when where age is equal to 17 is one of the like variable, and here inside like age variable I am having like 17 as a value, but here inside like age, I mean inside like age variable already we are having a 17 as a value, but here we are having the like 18 as a like one of the like number. So I am going to check the condition. If the age is greater than or is equal to 18, then only you can able to execute this block, otherwise you can't able to execute this block. If the condition is true, then only this block will execute. If the condition is failed, then in that situation it is going to work else part only it will work. So I am going to explain practically with the help of the like Visual Studio Code. So for example, consider here I am having one script tag, and inside a script tag what I am doing is, for example, I am having a where age is equal to, I am having like 17, where age is equal to 17 I am having. So what I am doing is, this 17 is the value I am assigning to a like age variable. Next line I am having the if statement. For example, if I am having here, what I am doing is age greater than or equal to 18, means if the age is greater than or equal to 18, then what we can say, that document dot println of, we will display you are eligible for OAT. And second condition, then we will check here whether it is like true or not. Means here where is nothing but one of the keyword, age is one of the variable name, and 17 is the value. This 17 is assigned to a like age property. Then now I am checking the condition. If the age is greater than is equal to 18, then only this block will execute, otherwise this block will not execute. So I already told you something about this one. I mean, so if the normally any program will execute the like from this top bottom or top left to bottom right, but with the help of the like control statement we are going to put the one particular condition at the particular line. If the condition is true, then only this block will execute. If the condition is not true, then particular block will not execute. So here I have already mentioned the condition in the like line number 5. So if the condition is true, then only this block will execute, otherwise it will not execute. So I am going to click here, I am going to give the right click, then you can get the like copy path. So I am giving the like control V, then check here. Why it is not displaying the any data? Because if the condition is true, then only it will display the data. For example, here I am putting the condition is 70 I am putting. If the condition is true, then only if block will execute. You can see here, you are eligible for OAT. Means if statement is showing the output if it is true. If the condition is true, if the condition is true, then only if block will execute. If the condition is false, then in that situation this if block will not display anything. But to show the something results to the like customer or like user, end user, we need to write the like else part. What we have to write? If the condition is true, then if block will execute. If the condition is not true, then else part will work. You are not eligible for OAT. So for example, here I am giving the like 17 as a age, or 10 I am giving. So in this case, check here. So in age variable I have given the like 10. Now what I am doing is, I am checking the condition. If A is greater than is equal to 18, so in age variable I am having only 10 only, but here I am putting the like 18. So here the condition is not matching, means condition is failed. So this block, if block will not execute here. Instead of executing the if block here, then else part is going to work here. You can check here. You are not eligible for vote. Means why it is showing this value? Means if the condition, I already explained you in the like theory part. So with the help of the control statement, we are going to check the condition. If the condition is true, then only particular block will execute. If the condition is not true, then particular block will not execute. So at the line number 5, I am going to check the condition. If this condition is failing, that's the reason else part is going to work. Then I'll one more thing. For example, if directly I am giving the means if statement will check the boolean condition whether it is a true or false. So in this case directly I am giving the true. Then if you are giving the true, means then document dot write illana. So if the condition is true, then only if block will execute, right? So directly I have given a true, then I am going to write if statement is true, if condition is true, then you can observe here what you will get. What you are, so in between this one I am going to give the one document dot write ln, one breakpoint I am giving. You can observe here. So one is the you are not eligible for vote. This is the else part is working. This is the if statement is working. If condition is true, means if is nothing but one of the control statement, it will check the condition. If the condition is true, then only if block will execute, otherwise it will not execute. Then we have to write the else part. Why we have to write the else part? Means if condition is true, then only if block will execute. If the condition is not true, then else part will work. Suppose in this situation I am going to give the this term FALS false I am giving. So if is nothing but one of the control statement, it will check the condition. Means if the condition is true, then only if block will execute. If the condition is not true, then else part will work. Why I am mentioning here the either true or false, means just to make you understand, because if statement is going to check the boolean condition. Boolean condition means it is checking whether the condition is true or whether the condition is false. If we give the false, then else block will execute. If we give the true, then if the condition is true, then if block will execute. If the condition is false, then else part will execute. You can check in the screen. If the condition is not true, then else block will execute and you are not eligible for vote also I have written. So this is the a control statement. So in the next video I am going to explain about the else if and switch statement. I am going to explain.